Nice to have your company this Monday morning. Since the Delta strain took hold in Sydney and then Melbourne, the average age of Australians admitted to ICU has fallen to 53.
Yes, significant change from the first wave of the virus in early 2020, when you might remember the average age was over 60 at 64. Well, Dr. Aidan Burrell is an intensive care specialist at the Alfred Hospital in Melbourne. He joins us now. Doctor, good morning to you. It's a big change. Do you know what's behind it?
Thanks. Good morning. We think there's probably two main reasons that's driving it. We've seen the rise of the Delta strain take over Australia in the majority of cases, and the Delta is highly infectious and affects all age groups. We've also seen the early vaccination was with the older population, and the younger population hasn't been able to be vaccinated as much, although they're catching up now. And that difference in vaccination is why we're seeing more cases in younger people.
So the people that are presenting to ICU, these younger patients, have many of them been vaccinated?
No. So at the moment in ICU, we have about 95% of people are not fully vaccinated. There's a small percentage who are, but by far the majority are unvaccinated.
Pretty simple, isn't it? At the end of the day?
Yeah, that's right. I mean, the vaccine is highly effective. Two doses work incredibly well at preventing severe or symptomatic disease. And what we're seeing is a lot of unvaccinated people coming to ICU.
And how are you going with the load and the number of people in ICU at the moment? Are you all coping?
Yeah, we're very lucky in Australia. We've got an excellent healthcare system, and at the moment we're coping. It is very busy. There are a lot of cases still in Victoria and New South Wales of COVID patients at various stages of their recovery. But you know, everyone's pulling together, and it's and at the moment we're coping well.
Doctor, there was an anti-vax rally, a fairly significant one, on the border yesterday between Queensland and New South Wales. Do you find any of that frustrating, especially considering that the border is going to open up in just a little over 4 weeks, and we don't know what's going to happen, obviously. Do you find that frustrating?
Look, we are happy to treat anyone that comes. Regardless of their status, we'll continue to treat them. I would just encourage people to get vaccinated. As I said earlier, it's highly effective at preventing severe disease. It's coming to intensive care, being put on a ventilator, is not something that people should go through, particularly when there's such an effective treatment to prevent it. Mm.
What about the presentation of pregnant women at the moment, more of them needing specialised care? How concerning is that?
It is concerning. We've seen in the first and second wave, very few patients were pregnant. And in this third wave, we've seen an increase. About 7% of admissions now in ICU are pregnant women of various stages of gestation. Again, there's been some concern around vaccination in that group, and so we've seen lower rates of vaccination in this population. Again, I would encourage people to take the public health advice and get vaccinated.
Do you think you're through the peak yet in Melbourne?
Well, hopefully. We're still very full. We have modelling that suggests that this is going to continue to be quite busy for some time, but you know, we're all hopeful that we can that we can get through this. I'm sure we will, but it's still going to be another. The modelling would suggest another couple of months at least. Wow. Of ongoing very busy times for us.
So you're all right with that?
Yeah. Look, the team is pulling together incredibly well. We've been preparing for this for really over 18 months now. We've got an excellent team pulling together. You know, we're OK.
OK.
It'll be nice when you guys can finally get a bit of a break, hopefully not too far away.